بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وأصلي وأسلم على نبينا محمد خاتم الأنبياء والمرسلين. We continue the explanation of the important lessons for the Muslim Ummah, and we have reached the point where the Shaykh rahimahullah mentions the chapters of the Quran that the Muslim is encouraged to learn and memorize as well as understand. And the surah we have reached is Surah Al-Asr, chapter 103. Surah Al-Asr. قال الله تعالى والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر. والعصر by Al-Asr, and we're going to explain the meaning of Al-Asr. Verily man is in loss. Man is in loss. Then comes the exception. إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, except those who believe. وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ, and do righteous good deeds. وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالْحَقِّ, and recommend one another to the truth. وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالصَّبْرِ, and recommend one another to patience for the sufferings, the harms, the injuries for which one may encounter in Allah's cause during preaching Islam or during jihad. يقول الله عز وجل, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most mighty, the most magnificent, says والعصر, أقسم الله عز وجل بالعصر, Allah swears by العصر. It is said that Al-Asr refers to the end of the day. And that Salatul Asr, the Salah of Al-Asr, tusamma As-Salatul Wusta, the mid one, is called or referred to as the mid one, meaning Al-Wusta as well means the best, as the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام referred to it. He referred to it as Al-Fudla, which means the best. The Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام named Salat Al-Asr as Al-Fudla, meaning the best. This is one saying. The second saying is إِنَّ الْعَصْرَ هُوَ الزَّمَانِ. عصر means the time, and this is the correct meaning. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes an oath by time. Why? Because of what takes place in it, from the changes of situations and circumstances and turning of affairs and the turning of the days amongst mankind and so forth, from what is witnessed in our times and what is referred to in the past. فالعصر هو الزمان. And thus Al-Asr is the time which people live, and these times differ in terms of their difficulties or ease, differ as to whether they are peace or wars, differ as to whether they people live there in a healthy life or in sickness, and people differ therein as to righteous deeds and as to evil deeds. All of these things are known, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes an oath by that, by the time that what? That man, إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَفِي خُسْرٍ, that verily man is in loss. Man here refers to mankind. The meaning therefore of the verse is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala swears that man's affairs, situation, circumstances is in loss in all of his affairs in this life and the hereafter, except those whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala except those whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala excluded. And who are they? إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, except those who believe. So the first attribute is that they believe. They believe. They are believers. So faith and iman, not mixed with doubt or hesitation. This is the iman, the faith which the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام described in his response to Jibreel عليه السلام when he asked him about faith. He said, أن تؤمن بالله, that you believe in Allah, وملائكته, and his angels, and his books, and his messengers, واليوم الآخر, and the last day, وتؤمن بالقدر, and that you believe in the pre-decree, it's good and it's bad. The explanation of this great hadith is lengthy, and in fact it was explained on several occasions. So those who believe in these six fundamental matters, these are the pillars, those who believe are the believers. However, the belief must be certain, not mixed with any kind of doubt or hesitation, that you believe in these matters as if you see them by your own eyes. And people in this respect are divided into three categories. First, مؤمن خالص الإيمان, a believer with sincere faith without hesitation or doubt, pure faith. The second, كافر جاحد, a kafir, a disbeliever, a denier. The third is hesitant, متردد. And the saved from these three categories is the first, the one who believes without hesitation, believes in the existence of Allah, in his lordship, in his godship or divinity and his names and attributes, and believes in the angels, and they are a world of the unseen. Allah created them from light and assigned to them tasks, as it is known, as some of it is known and some of it is unknown. Jibreel alayhi salam is trusted with the revelation, bringing it from Allah Azza wa Jal to the prophets and the messengers. And Mikael is trusted with rain and vegetation, all that is related to rain and all that related to vegetation. And Israfil is entrusted with the blowing of the trumpet. And Malik is entrusted with the keeper of the fire of hell. And Ridwan is entrusted with paradise. And from the angels there are those whom we know of their names, and there are those who we don't know of their names. And it came in the hadith from the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام that there is no place in heaven that can be occupied by four fingers except that there is an angel standing before Allah Azza wa Jal, or in ruku' in bowing posture or in prostration. Also, we believe in the books which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had sent down upon the messengers alayhim as-salatu was-salam. We believe in the messengers whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us about. We believe in them in person. And we believe in those whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't tell us about. We believe in that in general, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not tell us all of their names. قال الله تعالى in Surah Ghafir in chapter 40 verse 78, منهم من قصصنا عليك ومنهم من لم نقصص عليك. And indeed we have sent messengers before you. Of some of them we have related to you their story, and of some we have not related to you their story. And we believe in the last day, the day of resurrection, when mankind will be resurrected from their graves for recompense. They will be resurrected with bare feet, no clothes on, uncircumcised, and having no wealth. They will be gathered like that. And when the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam spoke that they will come naked, Aisha, may Allah be pleased with her, and her father said, Ya Rasulullah, الرجال والنساء ينظر بعضهم إلى بعض. O Messenger of Allah, men and women looking at each other. So the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام said, الأمر أعظم من ذلك. The matter, the affair is much greater than that. Meaning it's much greater than looking at each other, because everyone is busy with his own self. قال شيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية رحمه الله, شيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية may Allah's mercy be upon him, said, ومن الإيمان باليوم الآخر, and from the belief in the last day is الإيمان بكل ما أخبر به النبي صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم مما يكون بعد الموت, is believing in all that which the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام told us about what will occur after death. So we must believe in the affliction and in the trial of the grave, the test which the dead person will receive once he is buried and his company leaves him. There two angels will come and ask him, عن ربه, ask him, who is your Lord, ودينه, what is your deen, ونبيه, who is your prophet. We believe also that the grave is either a garden of bliss from paradise, or a ditch from the ditches of fire of hell, meaning there is torment or reward. And so also we believe in paradise and in hell and all that is related to the last day. All of this is included in our saying we believe in Allah and in the last day. And we believe in Al-Qadr, the pre-decree, the preordainment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This means we must believe that Allah Azza wa Jal qaddara kulla shay, preordained everything in due measures. And this is when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we know that when He created the pen, He commanded the pen, فقال له اكتب. Allah ordered, commanded the pen and said, write. The pen said, وماذا اكتب, what should I write? He said, اكتب ما هو كائن إلى يوم القيامة, write everything that will take place until the day of resurrection. So in that hour, everything that will take place until the day of resurrection is already written. إذن, so therefore, فالإيمان, when Allah says, subhanahu wa ta'ala says in this surah, إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, except those who believe, this comprises the belief in these six pillars. which the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam verified. So this is the first description, quality of the people whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala excluded as being not in loss. First is having faith and belief, firm belief. Second is وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ and did righteous deeds. Those who carry on by doing righteous deeds from salah, zakah, siyam, fasting and hajj, and good treatment to parents and keeping ties of kinship and so forth from the righteous deeds. So they don't only restrict faith to that which is in the heart, but rather they act accordingly. والصالحات, the righteous deeds, comprise two matters. Number one, sincerity to Allah Azza wa Jal. Second, متابعه, following the Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام. That is because the deeds, if they are not sincere and pure, then they are rejected. قال الله تبارك وتعالى, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the blessed and the most high, said in the hadith al-Qudsi, أَنَا أَغْنَى الشُّرَكَاءَ عَنِ الشِّرْكِ, I am the one who does not stand in need of a partner. مَنْ عَمِلَ عَمَلًا أَشْرَكَ مَعِي أَوْ أَشْرَكَ فِيهِ مَعِي غَيْرِي تَرَكْتُهُ وَشِرْكَهُ. Anyone who acts or does any deed ascribing partners therein with me in that deed, then I will leave him and his shirk. So if someone stands to pray showing off people or gives charity showing off as well, or seeks knowledge to show off, or keeps ties of kinship to show off and so forth, then these deeds are rejected. Although they may be righteous in their appearance. Similarly, the following, the ittiba', if you do something which the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not do, and you take it as a means of nearness to Allah, even though you may be sincere, but it will not be accepted from you, because the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam said, مَنْ عَمِلَ عَمَلًا لَيْسَ عَلَيْهِ أَمْرُنَا فَهُوَ رَدْ. Anyone who does an action which is not in our, or a matter which is not in our, in accordance with our command, then it will be rejected. So العمل الصالح, the righteous deed, is the one that comprises both sincerity to Allah Azza wa Jal, the second, the mutaba'ah, the following of the Messenger alayhi salatu wa salam. The third quality of those whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala excluded, the third quality, are Allah Azza wa Jal describing them, وَتَوَاصَوْ بِالْحَقِّ. The third quality, وَتَوَاصَوْ بِالْحَقِّ, recommend one another to the truth. Recommend one another to the truth. So they will recommend one another to the truth. And what is the truth? The truth is الشرع, is the revelation. So they will recommend one another to, if he sees him neglectful concerning an obligatory matter, he will remind him. Or if he sees him indulged in haram, in doing haram, also he will recommend him to the truth. He will tell him, my brother, carry on your wajib, carry on and do your obligatory act, and if he sees him doing haram, he will tell him, oh brother, restrain and refrain from doing haram. So they don't limit righteousness to themselves, but they try to benefit others. So they benefit and they benefit others by recommending the shara to others. The fourth quality, Allah Ta'ala about them, the fourth quality, وَتَوَاصَوْ بِالصَّبْرِ وَتَوَاصَوْ بِالصَّبْرِ, and recommend one another to patience for the suffering, harms and injuries, etc. So patience, and patience is refraining the self from doing that which it should not do, which is not fitting to do. And the people of knowledge divided as-sabr, patience, into three categories or three types. First, sabrun ala ta'atillah, patience for carrying on the obedience to Allah. Sabrun ala ta'atillah, patience to carry on the obedience upon obedience. Second, sabrun an maharimillah, sabr, patience to refrain from the unlawful, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decreed to be unlawful. The third, sabrun ala aqdarillah, patience for the upon the calamities which may befall someone. Concerning the first one, the patience on obedience, we see many people, for example, are lazy when it comes to performing the salah in congregation. You don't see them going to the mosque. He says, I will pray at home, and this means I had manifested what is obligatory upon me. So he becomes lazy. So we tell him, Ya Akhi, our brother, refrain yourself and be patient. Incite yourself to pray with the jama'ah, with the congregation. There are also many people, when they say that, when they see that the amount of their zakah is, they consider it to be too much, they're giving too much, then they become kind of hesitant and miser and so forth. We tell them, give this money. So incite yourself to carry on the duty of zakah. And similarly with all the actions of worship. And they are, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described them in Surah Al-Baqarah, in chapter 2, 45, وَإِنَّهَا لَكَبِيرَةٌ إِلَّا عَلَى الْخَاشِعِينَ. They are, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described the worship of Salah in this verse, the rest of the worships are like the same. And seek help in patience and of Salah, and truly it's extremely heavy and hard, except for the khashin, the true believers in Allah, those who obey Allah with full submission. You see many people, you find that worship is extremely heavy upon them, so they should be recommended and advised to be patient on carrying on the acts of obedience. Similarly, patience to refrain from sin. You see, for example, people are driven to earn, or they drive themselves to earn unlawful things, either through usury or deception and the like. So we say, يا أخي be patient, don't deal in ways that are haram. You see, many people are afflicted with the sin of looking at women. You see them on the street. Whenever any woman passes by, he or they will follow her with their eyes, with their sight. So we say, يا أخي اصبر نفسك, refrain yourself, be patient, and leave this unlawful matter. Also they recommend one another concerning the aqdar, the preordainment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A person may be afflicted by a sickness or by losing some of his wealth or by losing some beloved ones. So you see him in state of discontent and pain. So now they recommend one another, ya akhi isbar, be patient, this is a matter preordained, and acting in this way does not avail you and does not benefit you, and to continue on the grief does not lift the grief. Someone touched and touched by the death of his son, we say, ya akhi isbar, be patient. Think as if this son of yours was not born. Then, as the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to one of his daughters, inna lillahi ma akhad, really to Allah belongs that which he took, wa lahu ma a'ta, and to him belongs whatever he gives, wa kullu shay'in indahu bi ajali musamma, and everything is with him preordained for a certain time, up for an appointed term. فَمُرْهَا فَلْتَصْبِرْ, then command her to be patient, وَلْتَحْتَسِبْ, and to seek the reward. All the matters belong to Allah. If Allah takes that which He possesses, then how come you complain regarding that which Allah took? If it is said, which of these three types is harder on oneself? Which of these three types is harder on oneself? The answer, this depends. Some people, it's heavy upon them to carry on the obedience, extremely heavy. And others, just the opposite. Obedience is easy. However, abandoning the sin is very difficult, very, very difficult. Some people, it's easy for them to carry the obedience and be patient on that, and also on abandoning the sin, but does not in any way bear the calamities that may befall him. In fact, he could reach a stage where he may exit the fold of Islam. We seek refuge in Allah because of this. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described in Surah Al-Hajj in 22:11, وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ عَلَى حَرْفٍ فَإِنْ أَصَابَهُ خَيْرٌ اطْمَأَنَّ بِهِ وَإِنْ أَصَابَتْهُ فِتْنَةٌ انْقَلَبَ عَلَى وَجْهِهِ خَسِرَ الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ ذَلِكَ هُوَ الْخُسْرَانُ الْمُبِينُ. And among mankind is he who worships Allah as it were upon the very edge, in doubt. If good befalls him, he is content therewith. But if a trial befalls him, he turns back on his face, meaning reverse back to disbelief after embracing Islam. He loses both this world and the hereafter. That is the evident loss. So we take from this surah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala affirmed in this oath that man is indeed, all the children of Adam are in loss. They are encircled by loss except those who are qualified with these four qualities: firm iman, righteous deeds, recommending one another with the truth, recommending one another with patience. قال الإمام الشافعي, الإمام الشافعي رحمه الله said, لو لم ينزل الله عز وجل على عباده حجة إلا هذه الصورة لكفتهم. لو لم ينزل الله عز وجل على عباده حجة إلا هذه الصورة لكفتهم. If Allah سبحانه وتعالى did not send upon his عباد a proof except this surah, this chapter, then it would suffice them, would be sufficient, meaning it would be sufficient as an admonition and an incitement to stick to faith and righteousness and to call to Allah and to be patient on that. It does not, his, this does not mean that Imam al-Shafi'i meant that this surah is sufficient for the creation in all the matters of Sharia. Rather, it is sufficient as an admonition, because every sensible person, if he knows that he is in loss, except that he will qualify himself with these attributes before it, the attributes, so he will exert his effort to the best of his ability to be qualified with these four qualities and to rid himself from the loss. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from the successful winners. إِنَّهُ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٍ. He is all, able to do all things. This concludes, alhamdulillah, the explanation of this great surah, and which Shaykh bin Baz rahimahullah put amongst the chapters in the introduction for his book, The Important Lessons for the Muslim Ummah, and the explanation is based upon the tafsir of this surah by our Shaykh Muhammad bin Salih al-Uthaymeen rahimahullah ta'ala. Walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen, wa salatu wa salamu ala Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.